I grew up finding myself in the search for a reason why I got hearing loss. I was diagnosed with sudden sensorineural hearing loss when I was 4 years old, severe to profound loss in my left ear and moderate loss in my right ear. I had normal hearing when I was born, but at the age of four, there was a sudden loss in my hearing. And it was noticed by my parents one day. They came home from work and I was watching TV and the TV was really loud and I was sitting really close to the TV and that definitely alarmed them. My parents decided it was time to take me to a doctor. We went to an audiologist at the University of Michigan, got my hearing checked and discovered that there was a pretty significant loss in my hearing in a very short amount of time. Having a condition and not knowing why is one of the most terrifying things. My parents were very emotional throughout this period. It was hard for them to wrestle with this idea of having a child with hearing loss as severe as mine. That was kind of the beginning of the diagnosis, and then from then on, we kind of went on a very long journey of trying to figure out how it happened. When I got my hearing aid for the first time, I was 5 years old. I remember putting it on and turning it on, and it really did feel like the world came to life in a way. I started noticing that there were kids outside screaming and laughing. That was all stuff that I was completely oblivious to until I had turned on the hearing aid. The biggest thing of all was like just seeing the relief on my parents' face when they could finally see me realize how much I was missing out on. With the deaf community, when cochlear implants were introduced 20, 30 years ago, there was a lot of resistance initially because of that mindset that being hard of hearing or being deaf is something that needs to be treated or fixed. There are a lot of underlying deep injustices over the years that have led to that thinking. It's based in a reality that many people can't empathize with, and even me today sitting here can't empathize with. Over time, though, I think that there's been a more optimistic view of these technologies and aids. To this day, we really don't know how my hearing loss happened. Even after over 10 years of trying to see clinicians and going to different specialists, there wasn't really ever an answer. That desire to answer that question changed into a desire to find an effective measure to essentially remedy hearing loss. I'm a junior at Harvard College studying human developmental and regenerative biology. There's a lot of very interesting research being done using stem cells to regenerate hearing capabilities. And this is something that naturally happens in nature. Birds especially are an example of a group of species that can regenerate their hearing after they lose their hearing cells, so to speak. How do we take this idea of regenerating in nature? How can we translate that into humans? I started out that research with the regenerative medicine back in my freshman year. And after a year and a half, I realized that the time scale of impact of that research was actually a lot longer than I wanted. It's going to take decades for that research to come to life. After some deep introspection, I realized the kind of impact that I wanted to have in this field was on a time scale that wasn't decades, and more so was on the order of months and years. And that's when I decided that I wanted to pivot from focusing on stem cells and instead focusing on genetic therapy. What I do now at Boston Children's Hospital is I work with a clinician, and this clinician enrolls patients in genetic studies. And essentially what we do is we have these children who come in with hearing loss who don't know why they got hearing loss, very similar to my story, and we sequence their entire genome and come up with what are some genetic root causes that could be behind the hearing loss.
Less than 1% of the population, and then we can see like, oh wow, these are like really rare gene mutations.
We can actually provide some very convincing answers to these families. No, seriously. It's a very fulfilling kind of research because the time scale is almost immediate. This semester, I'm enrolling myself in the study, and the genetic sequencing that was available when I was younger was really, really not as thorough as what we have now. It's a personal journey that I think unless you're living it, you don't understand why the answer, why is it so important to have that. As someone who enjoys science, it also just keeps the wheels turning in my head.